When a man loves a woman and keep his mind on nothing else, he trades the world for the good things found.
Are you in the mood for love? I know we're not exactly dressed for love, but yes, it is the month of love. It is Valentine's, and you know you had to be tuned into.
It's the month for love, so yeah. I might as well.
Oh, okay. You're making me blush on camera. Yeah. Thank you. But you know, okay, as I said, it's the month of love, and you are on your number one leader. It is DBS, and it is time for season two of
the DBS's I Love You More Valentine's Couples Competition.
Yep, and believe it or not, we had couples fighting to be on the finals, or yes, should I say finalists, yes, to make it on air. Mm-hmm. So that's how many couples we have in love here in St. Lucia.
Yep, yep.
But it's about that time, because you know what? All of our couples have a different dynamic, different energy,
yes,
very different vibes and personality. So I think this season is definitely going to prove to be more fun,
yes,
than last season.
As you can see, I'm all dressed up. So you know the activities that we have is going to be epic. Let me get my warm-ups in.
I didn't come dressed for the warm-ups, but I am here, St. Lucia, for you. So while Shanra is going to be busy with the games, she's going to be with the couples, and I'm going to be right here for you. So she's going to do all that hard work, and we're going to sit back, relax, chill, and see how this journey unfolds.
But just in case you're wondering, we are right here at the beautiful,
lovely
Bay Gardens Beach Resorts.
Yes, so major shout out to Miss Patrick and the entire team, of course, because you know we have to start things off right. And right now, talking about starting things off, I think our couples are ready. We are ready. So if you are, Shanro,
get ready to meet our competitors.
All right, on your mark, get set, go! I told you I left all the hard work for her, right? So anyways, sit back and get ready.
Hi, St. Lucia. I'm Nokisa Alfred.
I'm Troy Greenidge.
This is my partner and I love him very much. We decided to join the show because I thought that this would be a great experience for the two of us. We've been together for a year and 4 months now.
For that year and 4 months, well, you know, how it is. We know relationship is perfect, but it's going great so far. And I'm looking forward, you know, to keep that going and everything. Nokisa and I met through like social media. It was my birthday, and then I got a message saying happy birthday to Troy. So I was like, who's that girl? And, you know, so I went, I watched the pictures she had on Facebook, and I decided she looks fine, you know. So I said I will give my a hint to see what would happen. Yeah, that's how we spoke, really got.
Our first date was on the beach. We met, we had a good time, we spoke, he told me about himself, I told him about me.
What I love about Lucasa, well, it's the food she just cooked. I like the food she just cooked, the company she just gave me, you know, at night, everything.
What I love about Trey is that he's very understanding and he always gives me good advice. Always.
I'm a footballer. I used to play for St. Lucia. My club is Monchi FC out of Grosley. I'm also the captain of Monchi FC. And, you know, I love playing the sport, and my soon-to-be wife, you know, the supporter.
I'm willing to support him in any way that I can to make him better.
I believe we have the strength and ability so that we could come out as winners. But everybody is a winner in the competition, but you know, at the top.
Hi, I'm Nikisha Thomas. This is Virgil Cyril. This has been my boyfriend for 2 years and months, right? I live Castries and Mondido. I'm 28 years. He's how old are you? 26 years. I think Vijay met me when I was going through a lot of depression, and he was always there to just always keep me from feeling down, and you know, always encouraging me and stuff like that to be a better person and stuff. And from that time, I just made up my mind and say, you know, I think that's a person I could be, right? So we just started talking, and from talking, we got closer, and that's how we've been together from day one. We hardly have drama in our relationship. We always good because we understand each other. Vijay know what I like, and I know what he likes, and he know what I would tolerate the same way I know what he's going to tolerate. So we don't really have a problem. He's not an outgoing person. He don't drink, he don't smoke, so he don't really like those kind of things. So normally I would do more outing, and he'd stay home. Sometimes he'd go riding or different things he have sometimes. Sometimes he'll fix bikes, sometimes he'll chill with his brother. He don't really have friends. So yeah, our life is so easy. We understand each other perfect.
Like I guess, I reach a point in time in my life like I meet somebody like actually changed me. I did like the person I used to be before, another kind of person again. The kind of things I used to be before, I can't really say now, but the kind of way I used to be before, like I can't just be so again. It's more humble now and more irony now because I meet her.
Hello, I work at a salon, and then we have some, all of us were there watching DBS. So my friend is telling me, Nikisha, that would be a nice thing for you and Vijay to do. I was like, girl, you're crazy. Vijay don't like TV, you know. She said, girl, I know you could make him do it. I was like, yeah, I can make him do it for sure. And then I say, you know what, let me just try something different. So I just joined the competition. Yeah, it was just easy like that. Taking part in the show would be perfect for me. But Vijay, he don't like those things, so it will be a little bit difficult, but we'll pull through. We'll work together as a team and everything will be okay. I work at a salon and we fix bikes, yeah. So you know, when you fix in the bike, that's not work.
Like, sell for somebody come and tell me they have a part, they can't sell it, I go just get somebody to buy it for them and I get a cut out of it.
When I go out, he doesn't sleep, huh? He would wake up, stay up until, he might go out and come home 5 in the morning. When I get home, Vijay is all awake, sitting up, waiting for me. And as soon as he see me enter the door and I lock the door, he just go and sleep one time. He's the best boyfriend. Yeah, he's a good person. We'll pull through.
Hi, St. Lucia. Hi, my name is Nicole Lynch.
My name is Ray Louis, and we have been together for 4 years.
And we have been dating since Carnival.
4 years ago.
I was jumping in somewhere Carnival band. Yeah.
Well, and I actually met her like friends. She was like dancing there and stuff. Like I was with my friends. When she passed with her friends, like I don't know, I like just continuously was staying at her and stuff, you know.
It was wonderful.
Well, I work security. I'm like what you call that? K9, and I work with people also.
And I work at Massey Stores Waterfront. What I love about Ryan, well, he's a very gentle man, decent, handsome, ain't he? Aww. I love him very much.
Well, what I love about Nicole is, wow, everything. I don't know how to start, where to start, you know? You know, the looks, the shape, the size, you know? She looks very beautiful to me, you know? Sexy, gorgeous, everything in one, you know?
We have only one kid. Her name is Bigita Miracle Naya Lynch. She looks like me and the daddy.
Yeah, she has features.
So we decided to enter the competition, well, to see how it is, like to know what it's about and stuff.
Yeah, pretty much that. Like we tried out to see, you know, if we would probably stand a chance. Everybody
is behind us. We'll win, you'll win, make sure you win.
I think
and
I get
stuff.
A migraine by that too.
Yes, we do. Every day, my lady, every day. And we're going to win this competition.
Hi, St. Lucia. My name is Elizabeth Cades. I'm proud to be St. Lucian. To be honest, I am in alone today because my partner is not and he couldn't make it because he's working at 6 to 2. But unfortunately, that's not a problem. I can handle this. I am 37 years of age. I live in Kaimoje Grozile. I'm from Sufre. His name is Franklin Henry. He's from Deriso. Presently, we have known each other for about 4 months. He's very funny, proud to be around. And to be honest, he makes me laugh. His favorite, he loves to sing. He's a very outgoing person. Same goes with me. We were meant to be, and we met, went out with some friends, and I met him that's in by a solo area, that's Marigold side, no, Lakwa, Mango. Yes, I met him there. We talked, we exchanged numbers. Then we took it from there. I'm a mother of three. He has one son. Our favorite drink, number one, I will not forget. Oh, we love the Bright. We can put this number one. Heineken is included, but Bright is number one, our favorite drink. And his special dish, oh, he loves his chicken, his fried chicken or stewed chicken with rice. Not forgetting his chicken wings. Something about he loves it very much. Now, sometimes before I cooked, he usually tell me how he wants it. I would ask him, babes, what would you love for lunch or dinner? He would say, okay, baby, I would want white rice or rice with mixed vegetable with stew wings. But not forgetting, his Bright is always there, which makes the two of us. We don't go out anywhere if we don't have a Bright. We decided to enter the competition, but honestly, I didn't know nothing about it. I'm working at Sandals Latok. When I came from work, he said to me, babes, we have something to do. I entered you into a competition, so I'd like, what is this? So then he's telling me, DBS has a Valentine competition, and he sent our pictures up. I was like, what? But you were supposed to tell me about it, but anyway, I took it in, I decided, and we both went. That's the first time I'm doing it, but I believe we are going to be number one, and we are the winner. Even if I'm there alone, I have backup. He will be the next four other sessions. He will be there, but presently he's not in. Fortunately, I had to be covering up for him. And we will be the winner, number one, guaranteed. Proud St. Lucia, Elizabeth Cadet, Franklin Henry.
We here at DBS are always full of surprises, and guess what? Right now we have a very special couple, a super sweet couple. That's my only clue to you right now. And they are here to have a special chat with our power couples for today.
My name is Frances Severin, better known as Marina, the fixing lady, Frances Rob, and my husband, Mr. Sugar. We took part in the Valentine's Day last year. And it was wonderful to see that we are the youngest group in the group last year. And today I'm just trying to share among them, let them know what's the meaning of love and what's the meaning of a relationship with a boyfriend or a husband. The relationship is not just like open an exercise book and to just close it back. You have to go through all challenges in life. And if you don't go through all that challenge in life, you will not see nothing that's good. And the first thing you must do in life, you must use prayer first in everything you do. Because without the Almighty, there is nowhere you can go. So my young people, I'm giving you all an advice in love and in marriage. You must expect there is something that will be wrong one day, but put it to be today. And not for tomorrow. Because life is not just like that. Life is love. Unity and peace and prayer carries you everywhere you go. In your life, in your marriage, in your boyfriend, in your girlfriend and family. So I'm giving you all an advice today. Not just go and get married and tomorrow you divorce. No, it's not good. You need to take the test of it and think of it. And see what it is, a marriage and a life living together. A life living together carries you everywhere you go and put the Lord first with it. And what I can tell you all today, the show that I have there for Valentine's Day is just not Valentine's Day alone. It is for every day. And that every day make you learn more and more to your children and grandchildren how to live life with a boyfriend and a husband. So what I can tell you all today, this is something to make you all learn today in that Valentine's Day. Valentine's Day is just one day, but love is there all the day. All the days, love is there. So please, today, make yourself feel proud to see that two young couples are there. Not old couples, young couples. We'll be 28 years. In fact, Wednesday will be my birthday. I'll be 57. My husband is 84, and it is a love. That's to show you, you need to know what's going in marriage. And it is not anything else than pray to the Almighty and give you strength. So it is a green banana and a ripe banana.
All right, St. Lucia, so you may notice that I have a hula hoop. In this challenge, our couples need to hold hands, never break that lock, of course signifying their love. At least I think that's why it was created that way. But the hula hoop needs to be picked off the ground, travel up the body, over through to the other partner down at the feet, and again, back up and over to the original partner's feet. All of this while holding hands. Again, they're not supposed to break lock. They're not supposed to use their hands to touch and hold. So I think this might prove to be very interesting. I'll give you a quick demo, although I wasn't prepared for this. And yeah, so basically, I don't know how they're gonna do it, but let's hope teamwork makes this dream work, because it ain't working for me. So guys, let's go check them out. Go.
Well, the first challenge was very difficult, right, Vijay?
Yeah.
Because you don't make me lose. I guess it, I don't know, like, it was very difficult, like, to try and keep the whoop up and then you can't use your hands or something. But I guess if I got a little more teamwork from, it would have been better.
Well, in the beginning, it looked impossible, but it wasn't impossible. You understand? It was a bit challenging, but we went ahead, we did what we had to do, and by the grace of the Most High, we came second place. So, you know, we were satisfied with what we had.
Oof, that whole lot was strange. That one is hard. That one was very hard. Like, to pull it up with your feet, and to, like, to put in the next person, that's a problem.
Though being first to complete this challenge, Elizabeth Cadet had to be disqualified for releasing hands and breaking the lock between her and her partner. The rules clearly stated that hands are to be held at all times, never releasing and breaking the lock.
All right, so that was interesting. Kudos to them. Hats off to our winners. I know I don't think I would have been able to do it, but somehow they made it. But right now, guess what? After all of that, everybody's hungry. So it's time to take care of those bellies. We are heading over to the High Tide restaurant. So let's go.
Thank you.
good afternoon, everyone. Yeah. Welcome to the Gardens Beach Resort, to the Hai Thai restaurant. Yeah, so how was your experience today?
It was wonderful.
Yeah?
And especially my steak, sir. It was very excellent.
All right, great.
Very, very excellent.
Yes. It's beautiful. So, you know, the way we prepare things around here, we infuse the local ingredients. Yeah, with the steak, so it was marinated in ginger and soya sauce overnight, and it was nicely seared in a hot pan, and with some olive oil.
Yeah. I could see it was well, very seasoned, good, no?
All right.
Yeah, it was tasty, no lie.
I'm glad you enjoyed.
Really loved it. My belly is boxed.
Right.
As in full. I take my time to eat.
All right, great.
Well, we had the roti, the seafood roti.
All right.
I had the seafood roti, and to be honest, yes, that's something I will eat again. That's delicious. I enjoy the roti. I enjoy it. They have some roti I taste before. Some of them a little too dry. Some of them a little too soggy. But that one right there.
Right. Perfect. You know, we're here at the Hai Thai and at the Sea Grips restaurant also. This is what we do. We use the local ingredients. You know, like local blend seasoning. You know, our chives, our onion, our shadow benny, we blend it with olive oil, you know, so we marinate it with, we use a lot of local seafood, like conch, octopus, you know. It take a while to cook, but you know, you do it a la minute, you know, so you have your mise en place there, and then, and everything we do it a la minute, so it's not like we have it there ready, so we do it to order, so it's nice and simple, so all the flavor is going to be there, nice and fresh.
So, one question, you do everything alone? I know you have somebody to prep the food, but I mean to cook everything for everybody individually. Do you do everything like that on your own?
No. Basically, I have a team there. So somebody's gonna work on the meat, somebody's gonna work on the veg, somebody's gonna work on the sauce.
And then you get to tell them what to do, right?
I give them the training. So we have an SOP, this is how we do it. We have recipes, so we follow the recipes so that the food can be consistent all the time.
Last question, out of your head, or you're following some kind of...
No, everybody have documents, recipes, okay. So that we can follow.
Okay.
But it's my job to taste and make sure everything is secure.
Well,
so if I give you a recipe and I'm not happy with it, so I'll have get rid of it and train you again and show you how to do it.
That's good.
This is the standard of the plate there.
Now, the mashed potato, I have had mashed potato, but to me this one, it was special.
Right.
Very special taste. I would love to know how did you go about doing this one also.
All right, so it's sweet potato. So you put your sweet potato to boil, and then you peel it off, you put it in a processor, food processor, with some cream, your salt, your black pepper, simple like this. And you know, you robo it and then you take it out and put it in a hot pan. Uh-huh. When you're ready to use it, you just put a little more cream to it. Salt, black pepper, nice and simple.
Well, once again, I did enjoy it. So let me ask, what about the after Valentine's? What about, are you all going to have any special or dinner for two or any special occasions?
Right, so we have our Sea Grips restaurant, which we have, it's a seafood restaurant, you know, and we do everything locally, so we always have local seafood there, you know. So you can get your pot fish, you can get your local crab, you can get your conch, you can get your lobster when lobster is in season. So everything that you can get with Hai Thai, you know, we always have special, like you know, different specials. And Saturday nights we have our beach barbecue on the beach. So like different huts with different places where you have your grill, you have your hot dish, you have your desserts and everything, which is nice and reasonable because with Big Gardens, it's owned by locals, so you know, so we work with the locals, so it's affordable.
Okay.
So you can afford to have a buffet. And Wednesday night we have plantation night, which is a buffet again, and you know, it's nice and reasonable. So we always have something going on. So Valentine's Day, so we have a buffet for Valentine's Day. It's very reasonable, so you can eat as much as you can, and we're going to have different booth with different stuff. And again, with Big Gardens, we infuse our, you know, our dish with local ingredients.
Okay.
So, you know, we use passion fruit, we use sorrel, we use ginger, we use shadow benny.
Lots of local stuff.
Right.
Which
right.
is herbs.
Yes. And we make it happen. So we have a romantic dinner, you know, at the Sea Grips, which is plated. and we have a buffet here. So, you know, it's very reasonable and you can afford to pay for it. Yeah. So like, for example, we're going to do a shepherd pie out of various short rib. And then we're going to use like yam instead of using potato. So this is how we do our things around here. All right, so I want to thank each one of y'all to Bay Gardens. I'm happy that y'all had a nice time, and I know definitely I'll see y'all again, right? So I'm hoping to see y'all for Valentine's. All right, and
no doubts about that.
I wish y'all, yes, yes, and I wish y'all good luck on y'all's show. All right, hope I'll see y'all again.
This is our next challenge. Now it is our balloon cup pyramid challenge. Now with that said, I think I'll call it aka the trust challenge, but with this it's a tag team sort of feel because our couples first decide who's going to be first to represent, and they are allowed, if things, or as they say, if the going gets rough, they're allowed to tag their partners so they can swap in. The aim of this game is for them to blow the right amount of air into their balloons so that way they can transport their cup from one side of the table to the other to build their six cup pyramid. Now with that said, zero, absolutely no hands allowed. If the cups stumble over, then they're allowed to use their hands to build it back up, and they start all over from ground zero. All right, so first couple to their six cup pyramid wins.
Go.
Challenge was the balloon in the cup. I found that it was a bit difficult, but it happened so easily.
The second challenge was good.
That was very easy.
Very. So we did go.
Well, the cup was okay, but once again, disappointed because I really thought Vijay wasn't able to do it. And when he helped me halfway, he was able to write. Because if you had started the first time, we would have continued, right? And we would have won. So it was difficult for me. So maybe the next time when I get more help from him, it will be better.
Though being first to complete this challenge, Elizabeth Cadet had to be disqualified for using her hands. The rule stated, no hands are to be used in the cup balloon pyramid challenge.
So I'm feeling a little bit cozy here, but you know what? This spot is the location of our next challenge. Now, our couples might be getting cozy, but not too comfy, because in this one, they're going to play a little game of Valentine's Day charades. So the couples get to decide which person is going to act out and who's going to say the words. The aim is that they need to guess as many words as possible, Valentine's associated, within 40 seconds. Of course, the partner can decide to skip a word and come back to it later. So in this one, let's see how well they can play charades.
Go. 18. Relaxing and eating. Pass. Edible. Love your heart. Candlelight.
Eating. Next thing, okay, girl, you can listen to nothing you can do. Love, heart. Fire, what, candle? Flower.
Come on.
Come yourself slow, man. TV.
Is that really slow? Actually, that one was movie.
Movie? Oh, why did I say TV? Okay. That's, yeah. Dinner. Heart. Candle.
A very pleasant yet unexpected surprise popped in for Elizabeth. Her boo Franklin made his appearance to the show.
Go.
Gina. Love. Heart. Candle. Pass.
She says pass. 14 seconds.
Mirror?
No.
7 seconds.
Dance?
That's it. Time's up.
Well, the show read well. I came late, I said. In fact, I came late, but I still enjoyed. I made it up to you, so that's all I have to say.
The last challenge, once again, it was difficult because of... Because... What? Everything is your fault. Because I didn't get teamwork again. So you know what? I guess the next show will be better because I'll talk him out of it. Maybe he wasn't comfortable and stuff, so it will be better. Right, Vijay? So I guess we still have that thumbs up for winning, right?
What? Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
No, that one's a
well. Well, the
I
first
didn't feel that one.
It was strange.
Like I tell you, I wasn't feeling it, so.
Well, the last challenge, which was the action and the talking, it was a bit difficult because, you know, certain actions you might want to think like, what you talking about? What, you know, what are you about, but, you know? But it was a nice challenge, you know, everything went out smooth and nice.
How are you feeling?
It's been a long, interesting, but fun-filled day, that's for sure.
Definitely. And of course, that was our last challenge, so it means Shanru can relax. I'll treat her to a massage, you know, and all that good stuff.
I'd really appreciate that.
Next year.
Muelas.
But how is it today with the couples?
I mean, being with the couples and actually, you know, coordinating the games, it's been very interesting to kind of have the different personalities, but it was fun. I enjoyed myself just watching, you know, so it was a good day, and I hope the couples, they themselves, or well, should I say power couples, that's what I like to call them. Definitely. I hope my power couples, they themselves had a good day. As you can see, your girl was decked out. I wasn't really in the fun, but I made the fun happen, you know, so I'm really hoping they enjoy themselves today.
Definitely. And you know what, this is going to be our opportunity to hear from our power couples themselves, exactly how they enjoyed today.
Well, we try our best. We tried. We really tried. Well, the challenges was okay. The food was wonderful. I think my belly's packed. I can't really do anything again. I don't think I do anything.
Like you said, yeah, we met new people. You know,
we laugh a lot.
Kind of had a little vibes, you know? Yeah, the vibes was there, man. The food was there too, you know? Like, you know, the usual. If we win, we win. But we're trying our best, that's
we
all.
We try. I can't wait to know what's going on next week. I'm very anxious for the next week. Very. I hope it's easy this time.
Well, boy, Cassie, yeah. You're coming back, but Cassie, I'm coming back strong. See?
Why you say that?
Because can't tell the future.
We're coming back strong, baby.
Yeah?
We'll have to work out something, but we have to try. Yeah.
I enjoyed the day today, especially, you know. I haven't been in that hotel for a while. You know that I enjoy everything. The eat, the food, the drinks, everything. Yeah, it was a blast. You had a fantastic Sunday.
Huh? We had a great Sunday.
Of course. Yes. And next week, Sunday, just watch out for the two of us, Mukisa and Troy. That we'll be coming out there to win, to be champions.
Best,
you know,
of our ability.
Yeah.
Well, with the hula hoop, like somebody was supposed to be in, and like he was okay. I was supposed to, the hula hoop is on the ground, I was supposed to be in, and you're out, and we have to try and, we have to hold hands. You're not supposed to drop hands and pass it through from my body to yours and from yours back to mine. And it was fantastic. It wasn't enough, but it was great. And I wish you were there also. I miss you so much. If you were there, it would be more fun. Now, with the balloon and cup, to be honest, she mentioned that, she explained to me, but I didn't understand. I ended up holding the, I wasn't supposed to hold the balloon with. When I blow, I was supposed to blow and shift the cup to make a pyramid. But I ended up holding it with my hand, which I shouldn't do. But I came out first, but still I did it wrong by holding the cup. I'm sorry. You love me? You still love me? Yes, and we also had lunch. Oh, you was missing, love. I had steak, I had mashed potato, rye banana and salad, pineapple juice.
Well, for sure, next week I'm going to be there. That's the 2nd of Sunday. I'll be present. I'm going to be there. So look out for me. Us, right? Us.
Yeah. Bye, Lucia. We'll be right back.
When a man loves a woman, can't keep his mind on nothing else. He trades the world for the good things